Okay, so check this out. Right now, video cards are still extremely overpriced. Even a 5700 XT is going for over $600 in most places. And when the 6600 XT came out, like usual, the shelves were completely empty after just a couple of days. So how about a whole computer for under $600 that'll play most of your games without problems? That's what today's video is all about. So let's jump in, let's talk tech, $600 system style. Let's go. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to the Your CD Key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. All right, so before we jump into the video, I would ask a kindness of you people out there, could you please like and share my video on social media? And if you like my style, please subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so that you know I'm making videos. With that said, let's talk about this $600 system. So first up, we have the AMD Ryzen 5600G. Now this is a great CPU, especially for gaming, and if you're not doing a whole lot of content creation, this will be absolutely perfect for your gaming needs. Plus, you can always upgrade later. Now for the motherboard, we have the Gigabyte B450M AM4 Mobo. This is a solid motherboard with lots of good reviews across the net. It's well priced, and it's also a nice motherboard that has a lot of expandability as well. Now for the memory, we have the G-Skill Ripjaw 16GB kit. This is DDR4 3600 CL18 memory. For your boot drive, we have the Kingston A400 120GB SSD boot drive. This is perfect for putting Windows on, and you've still got some room to drive for games if you want. Now for the storage, we have a 1TB Seagate Barracuda 7200 RPM hard drive, which is perfect for storing your games on. For the case, we have a really nice case for this build, the NZXT H510 mid-tower case. Lots of room inside the case. If you want to upgrade later and put a liquid cooler in or put a video card in, you've got lots of room inside the case to work with. Now for the power supply, we have the EVGA Supernova 80 Plus Gold fully modular PSU. All in all, for $600 or less, you get 6 cores, which is future-proof for years to come, 16GB of memory, plenty for any current games and running multiple apps at the same time, an SSD for your OS, a hard drive for games, which is a good mix of speed and capacity, an 80 plus gold power supply, which is very efficient and CEC compliant. It's also very power efficient. The chip is 65 watts, which makes it run cool and use minimal power. This is a great upgrade path as well, because the case has room for extra drives and the power supply has headroom for a dedicated video card once the market is in a dumpster fire. Now the big thing to consider right here is that you can build an entire system for under $600 that actually cost less than most of the video cards that are on the market right now. I know some people are gonna scoff out there and say, oh, you know, the APU isn't going to power my AAA games at 120 frames per second, but as we've showed you before, and Kyle from Bitwood has showed you, there are lots of games that you can play for up to 100 frames per second, and many of these games are the top 10 watched games on Twitch. Plus, you can play some of the AAA titles on here. You're just not going to be getting a huge amount of frame rates, but it doesn't mean that you can't game. And also, if you want to upgrade in the future and put a video card in the system, you can do that as well. Now, One question I got a lot of in the last build is if you can actually put a video card in and use it with the APU like Crossfire. No, you can't do that. But with these new APUs, you get all of the features that you get from any of the other video cards that are out there. I mean, everything. You get FSR, you get the smart access memory, you get, you know, all the different FreeSync stuff, you get boost. I mean, everything else that you get with this APU. And it runs really cool. It comes with its own little cooler, so you don't have to worry about any of that stuff right off the bat. And if you're a person who wants to overclock and do some other crazy stuff, you can easily change out to a liquid cooler in the case that we have chose for this particular build. Another thing is, we notice a lot of people are always using PC Parts Picker to choose the build. And in the past, I usually just use the parts that I have in stock. And a lot of times, those products were really expensive because let's just face it, most of the time when companies send out review samples, they're sending out the top of the line stuff. So even though I bring these builds to you guys, a lot of times you guys would say, hey, those builds were actually great, but the price was just too high. So we decided to do it a little bit different this time around. All of these parts that we have chosen this particular build, you can go over to PC Parts Picker, pick them out, get them in your cart, and it's under $600. And like I said, this system will game. So if you're a gamer and you want to play games, why sit around and wait till video card prices drop? You can get a system now, and when video card prices are back to normal, you can stick a video card in there and be good to go. This CPU or APU, whatever people want to call it these days, is powerful enough to play all of your games. It can do some content creation. If you want to spend $150 more, you can get the 5700G. It's an eight core 16 thread CPU. This is a little bit of a lower CPU, but for gaming, it's absolutely perfect. There's really no difference that you're gonna notice in gaming between the two CPUs. It really comes down to how much content creation, rendering, and other stuff you're using with your CPU slash APU, whatever it is at the time. So I appreciate you guys for watching the channel. You guys are an absolutely wonderful audience. Peace out. If you'd like to keep the channel sticking around, buying one of those codes in the beginning, they're always guaranteed by both me and your CD keys. And for a single dollar, you can support me on Patreon, and I give you guys extra love and a shout out on the channel if you do so. And also, I have a link down below for Amazon Prime. Try it for 30 days, and it'll help keep Tech of Tomorrow up and running. So we'll see you guys back here for more tech. Peace out. Love you.